Second Kings. Second Kings chapter 2. Praise God. Are you there? Second Kings chapter 2. I'm reading from verse 1. And it came to pass when the Lord would take up Elijah into heaven by a whirlwind. And Elijah went with Elisha. Elijah went with Elisha from Gilgal. And Elijah said unto Elisha, tarry here, I pray thee, for the Lord has sent me to Bethel. And Elisha said unto him, as the Lord liveth, and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. So they went down to Bethel. And the sons of the prophets that were at Bethel came forth to Elisha and said unto him, knowest thou that the Lord will take away thy master from thy head today? And he said, that's Elisha, I know it. Hold you your peace. And Elijah said unto him, Elisha, tarry here, I pray thee, for the Lord has sent me to Jericho. And he said, as the Lord liveth, and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. So they came to Jericho. And the sons of the prophets that were at Jericho came to Elisha and said unto him, knowest thou that the Lord will take away thy master from thy head today? And he answered, yes, I know it. Hold your peace. And Elijah said unto him, tarry, I pray thee, here, for the Lord has sent me to Jordan. And he said, as the Lord liveth, and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. And they went on. And the two went on. And 15 men of the sons of the prophets went, and stood to view afar off. And they two stood by Jordan. And Elijah took his mantle and wrapped it together and smote the waters, and they were divided hither and thither, so that they too went over on dry ground. And it came to pass when they were gone over that Elijah said unto Elisha, ask what I shall do for thee before I be taken away from thee. And Elisha, oh my God, said, I pray thee, let a double portion of thy spirit be upon me. And he said, thou hast asked a hard thing. Nevertheless, if thou see me when I am taken from thee, it shall be so unto thee, but if not, it shall not be so. And it came to pass, God, as they still went on and talked, that behold, there appeared a chariot of fire and horses of fire. Fire take this man to heaven. And parted them both asunder. And Elijah went up by a whirlwind into heaven. And Elisha saw it. And he cried, my father, that is the spiritual father, the chariot of Israel, and the horsemen thereof. And he saw him no more. And he took hold of his own clothes and rent them in two pieces. He took up also the mantle of Elijah that fell from him and went back and stood by the bank of Jordan. And he took the mantle of Elijah that fell from him and smote the waters and said, where is the Lord God of Elijah? And when he had also smitten the waters, they parted hither and thither. And Elisha went over. And when the sons of the prophets, which were to view at Jericho, saw him, they said, God, the spirit of Elijah does rest on Elisha. And they came to meet him and bowed themselves to the ground before him. Leadership and accountability. Amen. Verse now, in the first six verses, church, in this chapter, indicate how closely Elisha followed the prophet Elijah. The Lord sent Elijah to Gilgal. And Elisha said, as the Lord liveth, and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. I'm not going to leave my pastor. The Lord sent Elijah to Bethel. And Elisha said, as the Lord liveth, and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. The Lord sent Elijah to Jericho. And Elisha said, as the Lord liveth, and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. The Lord sent Elijah to Jordan. And Elisha said, as the Lord liveth, and as thy soul liveth, I will not leave thee. Amen. And they both went on. You see, Elijah mentor Elisha. Yes. God, now that's what you call leadership and accountability.
Yes.
Elisha was accountable to the man of God. And he did not leave the man of God until the man of God was raptured. Watch this, church. This is how closely Elisha followed the prophet Elijah. The prophet Elijah urged Elisha to stay behind. But Elisha refused to stay behind. Hallelujah. Elisha was determined to follow Elijah all the way to the end. Praise God. Elisha, praise God, did not leave his pastor, hop to another church. He stayed with him. Amen. God, hallelujah. Now, this is what you call leadership and accountability. Now, Elisha was aware that Elijah's prophetic ministry was about to be completed here on earth. And praise God, his departure was near. So Elisha followed Elijah until God took him away. Church, commitment is a great word.
Amen.
Amen. Because why commitment is a great word? Because it will cause you and you alone as an individual to stand on principle and value.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Listen, praise God. Elisha's commitment to Elijah, amen, and to his prophetic ministry was unfailing. Now, here is where, praise God, the word tie in to back up what I just said in Hebrew chapter 13 and verse 17 say, obey them that have the rule over you and submit yourselves, for they watch over your souls, as that they might give an account, that they might do it with joy and not with grief, for this is profitable for you. Now obey those who have the rule over you, pertain to those believers, amen, obeying their spiritual leaders in the church. Listen, church, a godly leader who are called by God into a position of spiritual leadership and authority have a heavy responsibility to give an account to God. Amen. They care for your soul, amen, and your spiritual growth, amen, that God, praise God, has given, amen, to you, amen, to care for them. In Philippians chapter 1 and verse 6 says, being confident of this very thing, but he who began a good work in you will complete it until the day of Jesus Christ. That's why you can't be hopping from one church to another church. You will never grow and you will never know God. Because the Bible says, they that be planted by the rivers of water, they shall bring forth fruit in its seed. You have to get a base.
Amen.
And God respect that. Because as I continue this message, you will see the light where I'm coming from. Yeah. Now listen, the process of Christian growth and maturity begin when we accept Jesus Christ as our Savior. That's where your growth really begins. Amen. Praise God. But you must have stability. As believers, there are some things we struggle with. Amen. And we fall at times. But when we are discouraged or distressed, amen, by our failure, just remember, he who began a good work in you will complete it.
Amen.
Hallelujah, praise God. But he cannot complete it if you are not stable. Because if you're not stable, you can hop from one church to another church. You won't be bringing forth fruit at all. I guarantee you that. Praise God. Now, watch this, praise God. Remember, he who began a good work in us will complete it. Now watch this, verse 7 says, back to the text, and 50 men of the sons of the prophet went and stood to view afar off. And the two stood by Jordan. Now watch this, church. The sons of the prophet, they were located in Jordan. So you have to be located somewhere in order for God to use you. Hallelujah. Praise God. The sons of the prophets, they were located, praise God, by Jordan. Amen. Now, the sons of the prophet, they were located in Jordan, and they watched it. They prophesied by the power of the Holy Spirit. They prophesied fulfillment, amen, and obedience to God. A true prophet prophesied, thus said the Lord. Listen, church, that's why you must have a home church. And you have a home church for growth and stability. Hallelujah, praise God. Now listen, when you have a home church, you will be committed to that church in your attendance, your involvement, amen, and your financial support. When I say financial support, I'm talking about, biblically speaking, your tithes and your offering. That's one of the reasons why you don't select a church, amen, to go to based on friendship. You don't select a church to go to based on convenience. You don't select a church to go to based on tradition and entertainment. You go to a church for spiritual growth, spiritual enlightenment, spiritual success. That's why you go to a church. Amen. Hallelujah, praise God. And most people, they would not be comfortable in a church, praise God, that focus on God only, that focus on the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. In Romans chapter 10 and verse, she says, what's this? They just hop from one church to another. But this is what Romans chapter 10 and verse, she says, for they have been ignorant of God's righteousness. Oh God, going about to establish their own righteousness. And watch this. They have not submitted unto the righteousness of God. Amen. Now watch this. Two things that hinder people from submitting themselves to God's plan of salvation. One, ignorant of God's word or righteousness. Amen. And two, human pride. Hallelujah. What the thing that amazed me, what takes you 15, 20 years to get close to God? You mean to tell me it can take you 1 or 2 weeks, praise God, to get close to God? No, getting close to God means a lot of suffering. Yeah. Hallelujah. Now, in 1 Peter chapter 5 and verse 6 says, it says, humble yourself. It didn't say, okay, somebody's going to humble you. It says, humble yourself. The onus is on you to humble yourself. Praise God. Amen. Now, it says, under the mighty hand of God, and watch this, he will exalt you in due time. Not in your timing, but in his time. He's going to move you from point A to point B. Amen. It's not about you. Praise God. Amen. If you don't humble yourself, it means you're operating in the flesh. You're operating according to what your five senses tell you. You're not walking by faith, but you're walking by sight. Humility comes by learning to be submissive and to show obedience. One of the most difficult things for a proud person is to submit to someone else. Human nature. Listen, it is God's will for you to humble yourself and not to assert yourself against the will of God. Amen, praise God. I can always tell, praise God, amen, when, praise God, a believer in this church, they're listening to somebody, they're listening to false teachers. I can always tell, praise, because what they're saying is contrary to the true gospel that they're hearing here. I know it.
Amen.
Listen, people can become insecure when they focus on the differences between themselves and others. Listen, church, there will always be someone who's more wealthy. There will always be someone who is good looking. More good looking than you. There will always be someone who is more intelligent, who are more smart than you. But watch this. This is the thing. But eventually, life in this world will ultimately be over. And those differences will be meaningless. The only differences that ultimately matter is whether people have trusted in Jesus Christ for salvation.
Amen.
God, hallelujah. And when you trust in Jesus Christ for salvation, no doubt you will be, amen, eternally secure instead of being eternally insecure. Hallelujah. You see, when you understand the purpose, praise God, you don't look at numbers. Because God will provide the needs for this church. That's why I continue. image, righteousness, holiness, repentance, and I'm not deviated.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Watch this. Verse 8 says, and Elijah took the mantle and wrapped it together and smote the waters, and they were divided hither and thither so that they went on dry ground. That's a miracle, brother. Praise God, amen. Amen. Divide the water, praise God. So when you're walking on dry ground, you see a wall of water on the left and a wall of water on the right, praise God. Only God can do that.
Yes.
Hallelujah, praise God. He just tried the Jordan. Hallelujah, praise God. Now notice, by the power of God, the Jordan River opened and made a passage. Hallelujah, to walk through the Jordan. Now the word mantle is important. Why the word mantle is important? Because we are told in 1 Kings chapter 19 and verse 19, what is this? Elijah passed by and cast his mantle upon Elisha. God, hallelujah. You see, brethren, how important it is to serve with the man of God. Amen, brethren, because when you take over, praise God, you will even do greater than the man of God. Praise God, you're not going to deviate from the foundation, but God will bless you with tremendous revelation knowledge.
Amen. Amen.
God, hallelujah. Now, the word mantle here means a cloak. The mantle itself, church, is not the anointing, but it symbolizes the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Amen, praise God. So when Elijah, the prophet Elijah, passed by and cast his mantle upon Elisha, amen, praise God, who he continued to mentor, amen, it indicates that the Holy Spirit was coming upon Elisha to stand in the prophetic office and prophesy, thus said the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah, amen. Praise God, the Holy Spirit help, amen, them, praise God, amen, to function in their respective prophetic office. But after the resurrection of Jesus Christ, amen, praise God, and the day of Pentecost, amen, the Holy Spirit came, praise God, and abided within the Christian believers, amen, praise God. What this verse 9 says, oh, this is beautiful, this is so beautiful. And it came to pass, when they were gone over, watch this, brother, this is hard, that Elijah said unto Elisha, God, what shall I do for thee? God, hallelujah. Before I am taken away from you. God, I gotta do something there. Amen. Praise God. You see, you can't understand the word of God with your religious glasses on. You need revelation knowledge. Understand? You need revelation knowledge. Praise God. Notice how the prophet Elisha respond. He said, I pray thee, let a double portion of thy spirit be upon me. Praise God. Hallelujah. Now watch this, church. The relationship between Elijah, the elder prophet, and Elisha, the prophet in training. Hallelujah, amen. As an example of the influence of a strong mentor and a strong leader, amen. Now, when Elijah asks Elisha, what shall I do for thee before God take me out of this world? Mm-hmm. Amen. You see, watch this. Elisha knew exactly what he had wanted. Elisha had seen what God had done, amen, for through the prophet Elijah. That's why he's got to understudy a pastor. Hallelujah, praise God. Therefore, Elijah wanted to be God to use him more. Hallelujah, praise God. Elijah wanted God to use him more. So, praise God. So, Elijah requested a double portion of thy spirit be upon me. Hallelujah. Listen, church, my God. Before I go further with this, listen. A life lived for God will no doubt influence others to be sold out, amen, to God. Amen. Now also, it is important to invest in someone else what God has entrusted to you. You see, Elisha recognized the leadership, amen, of the prophet Elijah. Praise God. Hallelujah. That's why he did not want to leave his leader. Amen. The prophet Elijah was mightily endowed, amen, with the Holy Spirit. And Elisha realized that he could not follow the prophet Elijah, amen, step in his own strength. That's why the Bible said it's not by might, it's not by power, but it is by my spirit. That is what God told Zerubbabel in Zechariah 4:6. So, the humble Elisha, God honored humility. Hallelujah. Because he will raise you up not in your timing, but in his timing. God knows the exact moment when to raise up a man of God. Hallelujah. So the humble Elisha asks for a double portion of Elijah's spirit. This means, amen, praise God, Elisha requested that the same spirit that empower Elijah's ministry be given to me. Amen. So that I can continue where you left off. See, Jesus, the disciples, they were with Jesus all the way. And they continue where Jesus left off. They didn't preach something different. Amen. You see, church, Elisha realized the enormous task before him. And God granted Elisha his request at God's time, not in Elijah's time. Amen. Listen. We have to stay focused on Jesus Christ, amen, who is the supreme example of perseverance and faithfulness. Just as Elijah persevered in faith and wait on the Lord, this also applies to us. Now, just as Elijah, amen, was rewarded, Elisha was rewarded with a double portion, amen, praise God, we also will be rewarded at the right time. Amen. Amen. We just have to wait on the Lord for his power. Amen. Praise with faith. And God will fulfill his promise in the right time. Yes. Amen. Now in Hebrews chapter 11 and verse 6 says, but without faith, it is impossible to please God. Elisha pleased God. Because he waited, amen, praise God, for the next move of God. Amen. Now, many people claim to believe in God, but the question is, do they really know him? There's a difference there. Amen. Listen, to know God, it requires faith. Sure. You must have a willingness to believe God through faith. Amen. Amen. And his reward is certain. When you have faith, you will discover that you're having a personal relationship with God, and by trusting in Jesus, our Savior. Amen. Praise God, who died for our sins. Verse 10. Elijah told Elisha, why? You ask a hard thing. You need a double portion? That's a very hard thing. Hard thing, praise God. Amen. A hard thing, which means it is a hard claim. Now, Elijah respond indicate quite clearly that the issue rested solely on the Lord. Amen. Why? Because it is God who anoint, not man. Amen. Amen. Verse 11 says, what just now? Praise God. And it came to pass, as they went on and talked, behold, there appeared, praise God, chariots of fire. God. Amen. And horses of fire. This is to show you how great this man Elijah was. This man was escorted to heaven with chariots of fire. Amen. And horses with fire.
Amen.
God, hallelujah, praise God. And watch this. Elisha was with him. Because it says, and they parted them asunder. And watch this. And Elijah went up by a whirlwind into heaven. Into heaven. Amen. This means Elijah went to heaven without experiencing death on earth.
Yeah.
God, hallelujah. Amen. What is church? What a spectacle. What a sight to behold. Amen. Praise God. Now, this is a dramatic escort into heaven in triumph. To the very last, this great prophet lived for God and stood against sin and idolatry. Amen. Notice, Elijah went up by a whirlwind into heaven. This is just to show how close these men with God. How close relationship these men had with God. Praise God. God wasn't satisfied. Okay. Elijah, praise God. Call Elijah into heaven. But I got to send the, praise God, chariots of fire. Chariots of horses, God. Fire. Hallelujah. Praise. I got to send it for this man of God. When Elijah prayed, rain fell. When Elijah prayed, he shook an economy of an entire nation. Closing church. This is similar to the rapture of those believers who would still be alive when Jesus Christ returned. Now, the word rapture is not found in the Bible. Amen. But it makes a lot of sense to use it. You know why? Because it simply means to be caught up. That's what it means. It means to be resurrected. I have no issue with that. I'm not going to debate it. Praise God. But I know definitely that's what it means. Amen. Praise God. Amen. So, oh, praise God. It's similar to the rapture of those believers who would still be alive when Jesus Christ returned and remove his church from the earth and take it to heaven. For example, in 1 Thessalonians 4:17 says, then we which are alive, you see, and remain, shall be caught up together with them in the cloud to meet the Lord. Where? In the air. Now this refers to those believers who did not experience death. Because if the Lord return now, present, and our lives is in right standing with God, we will be caught up. How many of you glad for the Lord return now?
Amen.
I'm glad if you return now because I know my life is in right standing with God. I know that my garment is clean. God, hallelujah.
Yeah.
But if I'm living in sin, God, please, please, God, don't return now. I still have a lot of work to do. I still have a lot of cleansing to do. Amen?
Amen.
Praise God. Amen. So watch this. They will change from mortal to immortality. Why? Because flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God.
Amen.
This applied to the prophet Elijah. Amen. Verse 12 says, watch this now. And he took hold of his own clothing. Amen. And he rent them in two pieces. And verse 13 says, and he took up the mantle of Elijah. Watch this. Remember, he took up the mantle of Elijah. Because Elijah, praise God, could not enter heaven with his earthly garments. You have to change from mortal to immortality. Amen. Praise God. that fell from him and smote the water. But before Elisha took up Elijah's mantle, he took off his own clothing first. Then he took up Elijah's mantle and put them on. God, hallelujah. He put them on, pray. You know what that means? It means that Elisha is now Elijah's successor.
Amen.
Hallelujah, praise God. He is now qualified. You see, he had to wait for that appointment at the right time. He's not qualified to function in the prophetic office. And the same power, what is this, that accompanied the prophet Elijah, is the same divine power is now operating in Elijah. God, hallelujah. And verse 15 says, and when the sons of the prophets, which were to view at Jericho, what they saw him, what is now? Oh my God, this is important. Amen. They said, the spirit of Elijah does rest on Elisha. Now, this is what the sons of the prophet say. You see, the sons of the prophet, they witness Elisha follow Elijah to Bethel, Gilgal, and Jordan. The sons of the prophet knew that Elisha did not let his spiritual father out of his sight. It is good to serve. Hallelujah, praise God, amen. Now, notice, the sons of the prophet say, the spirit of Elijah, amen, rest on Elijah. Now, that is the Holy Spirit. Amen. Listen, church, I'm going to close here. If you follow your pastor closely, the same anointing will come upon you.
Amen.
Amen. How it will come upon you when you associate yourself with the man of God and you allow him to mentor you. That's why you have to be led by the Holy Spirit to follow a certain ministry. Amen. Praise God. If you are going to follow someone, make sure that person is following the leading of the Spirit and follow the God in that person closely. Amen. So I'm going to stop here. Praise God. Hope this word is a tremendous blessing to you. May God be to glory.
Great things he has done. Amen.
What are we?
Praise God. What?
Trials and temptations. What's up, y'all? I know a lot of you guys are trying to get closer to God, so I got some people I want you guys to meet. The missionaries. Now, I know what you guys are going to say. You're going to be a little bit...